I met the showman 25 years ago this month. It was 1993. I was retiring from the Army. A few weeks at the end of September, and I was at a house in the Hamptons owned by my cousin, Bruce Llewellyn, who was also a customer of yours, and standing in the garden, drinking something, and this guy comes up to me and he says, "How you doing?" He says, "I'm going to dress you." "What? I dressed Eisenhower? I'm going to dress you?" Well, how could you resist? So, when I did retire from the Army, this time I had three green suits with black ties and one regular civilian suit. Went down to his place, and he measured me, and he said, "You'll have it in a few weeks." Probably a few months. And when it arrived, it looked like just another nice blue suit. But I wore it to the White House. "What are you doing?" I wore it to the White House, and I was sitting in one of the front rows of an event, and there were a bunch of generals behind me, and so on active duty. And one of them tapped me on the shoulder and said, "Colin, where'd you get that suit?" I said, "Okay, I've hit it. And over the years, we have become very, very close. He has made a number of suits for me, and there have been some interesting things that have happened. He'd come to the house after he'd been up at Neiman Marcus City. He'd show me all the samples and whatnot. I'd say, "That's nice one. No, you don't like that one." go to the whole book, wasting time until he told me what I had to get.
If you know how to talk.
So we go down the place, and all of these master Italian tailors are there. And Martin turned to them as he's fitting me and said, "Well, what do you think about this?" And the master tailor was said, "I think it ought to be a little lower." "No." "So what you asking for?" But the funniest one of all was that I was on the Board of Governors of the Boys and Girls Clubs of America. I went to Kansas City one day to see a Boys and Girls Club, give a speech, and go out and play in the backyard of the club with the kids. And I didn't want to wear a Mark the Greenfield suit to go play soccer, kick soccer ball around. But I had forgotten that Time magazine was going to be there. And so I had an old jacket that I bought at the PX many years ago. And I wore it out there and played with the kids. Everything was fine. It was terrific. Time magazine comes out this evening, and the morning after, the next evening, I get a call. "What are you doing? What are you doing to me? What am I doing to you?" I said, "Where did you get that schmata?"
Sounds like
maybe it's one of your schmatas. "It's not my schmata." I said, "Come on, Mark, let's knock it off. Now, I know I'm supposed to wear your suits whenever I'm out in public, but I'm thinking I'm going to go kick a soccer ball in the open field. How would you know it's your suit? It's just a jacket." "How would I know it's my suit?" "The button. It's off a quarter inch. What are you talking about?" And, you know, delightful. I've never met a lapel like that. Never in my life. And so I said, "Mark, you're worried more about you than me." Of course, everybody will look at that and take it to a Mark Greenfield suit. My reputation will be ruined. So we kept going, though. And I was trying to tell my assistant today how many suits I had in Mark Greenfield. But it became too embarrassing, so I didn't take it. And it's not that I wanted these suits. Every time he showed up, he left with me with two more suits in it. And then I introduced him to my son. And my son has unusually injured in the Army, so he got a slight problem with his body physique. And so Martin went to fit him and give Mike a couple suits. And then he said, as he was leaving, "That was so nice of you." I said, "Yeah, what do you mean?" "You gave them to him for Christmas." "Who said I gave it to him?" "I say you gave it to him." And I got the bill a couple of weeks later. And my daughter is here. there's my daughter Linda. She's an actress, and Mark made it cook for her. The bottom line of all this, not to be here, is this is a man. The man has become a dear, dear friend. A man who has been an inspiration to all of us. And who came here with nothing. In the Holocaust, he learned part of his trade by doing things for the Germans. He survived. First time I went to this place, I said, "This is the place? The warehouse." It's like something like a Godfather too.
That's true.
That's right. Awesome.
Anyway, I climbed the steps, I got in, and it was the beginning of a long relationship of 25 years. We stayed in touch with each other, signed with the boys, and my wife for so many, many years. And I had to race up here. From New York and Amtrak was on time. And I just want to let you know that you can miss him. You're my man, my brother. I'm glad to be part of this crap, this book. Thank you.